Well, first of all, welcome to NEM, welcome to Zagreb.
Thank you.
I know that you flew in like 15 minutes ago, but I hope that you'll be staying long enough to enjoy a bit of Christmas spirits in Croatia.
Yes, and I'm looking forward because this is my first time in Zagreb, actually, so I hope to enjoy it to
then
the
welcome
very
again.
Last second. Thank you, thank you.
I'm sure you will. Let's talk business. You're a member of the jury this year for first ever TV writing contest. What made you say yes to coming and being here?
Well, I am programming for a training center, a program, a platform that is developing and helping to spread out all their talent, participants from Central and Eastern Europe. Mm-hmm. So this was a very natural step for us to partner up because we are on the hunt for talents from the region and we like to discover new people who are interested in MIDPOINT is the organization, mm-hmm. and we are looking into scripted mostly. Mm-hmm. But of course, some people, you know, balance both. So all about the networking and all about discovering new people. That's why I joined the jury for the competition.
So you had the chance to read all the applicants' work for this year's NEM. How satisfied are you with what you saw and read?
I was very satisfied with the diversity. There was a lot of themes that were streaming throughout all the applications, both in unscripted mm-hmm. and scripted. I'm very happy also in the top 10 that there was, I would say, a lot of a female voice or a female lead that was recurring in the projects that I was very happy about, that it signals a change. Mm-hmm. Also, there were stories and projects that were addressing, kind of making peace and coming with terms with the past or with traditions
Oh, really?
Under the society.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
Also in a fun form and also in a dramatic form. Mm-hmm. So that was very refreshing. That mm-hmm. I thought is a good signal of a modern era of mm-hmm. serialized writing.
You said in your first response that you were seeking out for talent from Central and Eastern Europe. How talented are we?
Wonderfully, wonderfully. I was surprised when we opened up the program. The first year of applications, I was a little bit wondrous how this will go. Is there enough stories? But in fact, yes, the talent is out there. And there are many stories that need that serialized, that formative series, that multiple storytelling layers to go through some of the subjects that they're tackling. Mm-hmm. So I think that the talent is certainly there.
And you know, in recent years, everything is recent to me. but in reality, in the last 10 to 15 years, Scandinavian noir is like everything Scandinavian and has made a huge impact on a global scale. Do you think that, and it's very recognizable, you can see just a glimpse of something on TV and you can say, well, I think this is Danish or Baltic or whatever. Do you think that this part of the world, this part of Europe, can have a signature that is like Scandinavian, but in some other ways?
Certainly, certainly. I think the trick there is to find our own voice. Mm-hmm. And I think that the trend, that is the international trend, is not about bringing projects that are universal. They are the ones that are staying true to their local core. They're the ones that they're authentic. They are not playing games and being something that they are not. And if they do have that strong voice, I think that is what elevates them to the international mm-hmm. level. So, and yes, exactly. The Nordics series are a perfect example of that, but also even smaller territories such as Israel mm-hmm. Became, you know, a very strong lead and a very strong voice in the overall spectrum.
So all I can say at the end, well, happy hunting.
Thank you very much.
You have lots to do, and hopefully we'll see each other in the Dubrovnik.
Hopefully. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Have a lovely day.